Your boy Untold Insight. Today we're going to be talking about a company called Diamond CBD. And if you ever heard of that company, you'll see a lot of reviews out there saying a lot of positive stuff about them. They had a sale, so I decided to pick some stuff up, you know, some CBD, save some money. Now there were some few things that I found wrong with this, and I decided to share this information with you guys next time you decide to buy, not just specifically from this company, but any company in general. These are the misleading things that I talk about, that there's a lot of misinformation out there that people should start sharing and be a little bit more transparent with. I see a lot of reviews and a lot of people just say things and they just like say it without no meaning and it has like nothing behind it. And I think that's an actual scary thing. Like whenever you look at somebody give this actual review, they'll say what's the ingredients and some of the things inside of it. And it's like they're not listening what they're saying, and it's kind of like, I think that's where the problem lies. So here's my take on this, and this is my personal opinion. Now, Diamond CBD sells a lot of different CBD products, not just their own in-house, but other companies. Now, I'm going to be reviewing their specific brand, which is the 30 milligram edible CBD gummy. Now, it says on it, automatically on the packaging, which is actually nice. I have no problem with that. It says you must be 21 and over to purchase, which I'm fine with that. But it says do not exceed more than 1 to 2 pieces every 6 hours of CBD. Now, to me, that does not sound right, because if it's pure CBD, why would you be putting do not exceed this? Let's just say somebody's taking this for pain purposes. You have to find your right dosages and actually to help with your pain or for your anxiety. Everyone's different. Products affect differently, right? Especially as well as CBD. It goes for anything. So that on it alone, it bothers me. I just don't know why. It just doesn't sound right to me. Well, we'll continue on. Why else I think there's a major issue. Now, this lets me know that there's just not CBD in it if they're writing that. So I decided to turn it over and actually look into the ingredients myself. And here's where I found the biggest problem about this. For one, there's melatonin in here. Now, melatonin put inside with CBD, fine. If you want to do a combination, good. But just don't put on the actual packages itself that it's natural CBD infused. Okay, don't do that. Make sure on the packaging that you state that there's also melatonin in there. That way people can know, because melatonin is a substance that helps you get very deep rest. You understand? It's kind of like a hormone. We produce this inside our head in our pineal gland, but a lot of these people that are doing this review, they're not actually saying this. So whenever you're taking melatonin, it helps you rest. It doesn't put you to sleep. It might get you a little bit more relaxed, but it helps you get deeper rest when you actually go to sleep. But it also helps in here. So do know that this is helping the CBD feel a little bit more stronger when you're taking this, just knowing that there's melatonin in here and not stating this on the actual front of the actual package, you know. That, I think, plays a huge part. It's like you're putting it there very small, but it makes a difference. And then secondly, when you keep reading, you see that it says a proprietary blend. A proprietary blend of what? Most likely is going to be of a bunch of herbs. You need to put the actual herbs on the actual ingredients, because some people may be allergic and they can actually get real sick if they take something in here. For instance, there may be some chamomile extract. It's part of the ragweed family. Someone can get very allergic to that because it's almost like you're allergic to hay. Also, there can be other things in here which can be like passion flower. It deals and it messes with your MIOs inhibitors. These are things that people need to know. There could be skullcap in here. There could be whatever in here. People need to know what's inside this proprietary blend. You don't have to put the amount of dosages if you don't want to give away your recipe. Fine, I understand that. But make sure that you put what is the proprietary blend? I'm just guessing that it could be herbs, because that's what I'm guessing. But even if I'm wrong and it's not herbs, I still feel that you should at least write the names of what's inside of here. You don't have to disclose the amounts, you know, but you should write it, because someone could be allergic to it and take this product and think that they're actually feeling something when they could actually be getting wrong reactions. And secondly, look at it in another perspective. There's a proprietary blend in here also with melatonin, also with CBD. This is then why people are giving this great reviews, because it's like, hello, you're not just taking just pure CBD, guys. You're taking multiple things that is making it stronger and feel much more stronger. You're taking something that's going to first help you get rest, and then you're taking a proprietary blend of other things. If there are more relaxants in here, of course it's going to make it feel more relaxing. So now you have to actually question the actual product. But like I said, most of these people, when they're doing their reviews, they do not point this out and they do not show this to people. And this is critical. You need to know this because, like I say, people can be allergic and this can be misleading with this company. I found this automatically wrong when I saw this. And for me, and I only took half a gummy and I felt like this was very strong. Something that CBD shouldn't have felt like this. And I know this because of I try a lot of other CBD products that just only contain CBD. And they never make me feel like this. This was the only thing that I've tried so far. I'm not going to talk about the other ones, but they're kind of similar and the same thing I'm going to talk about. But this one specifically was very strong. And it wasn't just for me. I gave it also to my girlfriend. She tried it. Same things. I even went as far as feeling heart palpitations with this. My heart started to speed up, and that let me know that there was something wrong as well. Like I said, I had no other problem with any other CBD. I'm not bashing this, but I would have appreciated if this company would have put what's in that proprietary blend in the back. Like I said, someone could be allergic and there could be very bad things and you can get very bad reactions from stuff. And I think that should be talked about, and a lot of these other reviewers are not talking about this, and I think that's where the problem lies. You know, and like I said, melatonin should be put in the front and the ingredients should be written a little bit bigger in the back for people to know. This is your boy Untold Insight. And like I said, I'm going to be honest and I'm going to put out my information that I think is valuable for people. This is not just about making money or saving money. This is about finding good products that help people and stuff like that. And if it's, I'm not only going to be putting things out that I think are just good. If I find something wrong like this, I'm going to call it out. I'm not dumping anything on the company or saying that it's completely wrong or their product is wrong, but these little minor things I think are wrong that I pointed out in this. So hopefully this is helpful for everybody. And now know, when you look for CBD, make sure you know what you're looking for and make sure that it's 100% just CBD. Now if you want one with a blend, fine, but make sure you know what's your blend. Just don't say proprietary and you don't even know what other things are inside. All right, peace and love everybody. To the next review, it's your boy Untold Insight, Forbidden Truth, and we out.